over here we have the winner for the season. I mean, this guy, this sage grouse, he's surrounded by females. There've got to be, I don't know, 20, 30 females around him right now. And you can see other males in the background with none around. I mean, they'll be lucky to get one mating. Most of them will get none. He can mate with all these females today. Oh, you can see she's soliciting there. Puts her wings out to the side and basically says, "You're the one." He's been out here for a month, as of all those other guys you can see in the background. But he's the one who's gonna mate with all these females today. He's the elite male. There might be two of them on the lek who are gonna get 75% of the matings. I mean, by the end of the season, he may have mated with 60 females. And each clutch might be 7 eggs, 50 females. I don't know, you do the math. That's a lot. But what is it? What is it about this male? Even though he's coming in here every day and he's working really hard, he manages to hold weight, keep his energy up. It's not pacing himself. It's just that he can. His neighbors, who still look like they're going at it, those guys have lost weight. They're having a hard time doing it. He's one of the few males out there who can just keep doing it. And those are the good genes that those females are picking on. It's because each of those females can all choose the same male that we have such extreme sexual selection. He does no parental care. All he does is provide genes to the next generation. So if they all like his genes, then they'll all look more like him next year. And again, and again. And then you get these super tuned, highly amazing displays.